So this is a lesson for 3- and 4-year-olds about identifying the difference between a word and a letter. So my lesson today is with my big hungry bear, and I just made this bear out of a cardboard box, and I have a little mouth that can open and shut, and I have some fish that are drawn on some paper. So on these fish are either words or letters. And I tell my students, my big hungry bear is very hungry, and he only wants to eat words. Now, we've already talked about how letters are all alone, and words have many letter friends. So, the big hungry bear wants to eat as many letters as he can. So that means he needs a word. So I'll ask my students, can you come and find the big hungry bear a word to eat? So they'll walk up to where I'm sitting and they will look at my choices and hopefully they can find a word. If not, that's okay, and maybe you could start by pointing at one and explaining that, look, there's many letters on this one. And then they'll pick him up and they'll slide him into the bear mouth. And then what's so fun about this is you can go, nom, nom. And they think it's so funny because that bear is eating their word. And then I'll have another student come. And this is also fun because when they pick up this word, they're interacting with it. They're looking at it. They're seeing maybe they already know that that's an E. So that can be exciting too. Let them tell you that. It's okay to talk about what they see. So they're gonna come and they're gonna grab a word. They're gonna put him in his mouth. And again, I'm gonna say, om nom nom. Oh, thank you. So when all my words are eaten, what's gonna be left over is just the letters. And so we'll be able to see, oh, these fish got away because the bear only wanted our words. So again, this is my way of explaining again the difference between a letter and a word for 3- and 4-year-olds. So in my lesson, I used a box that I made into a bear, but you can use whatever materials you have on hand. You could draw on an envelope and feed the letters to your frog, or you could even use a puppet and feed your puppet the letters or the words.